liquid crystals are a kind of matter that exists somewhere between a liquid and a solid. When we think about matter, it's usually in one of three distinct states: solid, liquid, or gas. But some things don't quite fit perfectly into one of these categories, like Jell-O. Not exactly solid, not exactly liquid. Liquid crystals are this way too. They can flow like liquids, but they have some properties of solids. They maintain orientational order, meaning the molecules are mostly pointing in the same direction like a solid, but they've lost the positional order associated with solids because they aren't perfectly aligned in all directions. Meanwhile, liquids are pointing all over the place. And gases? Let's not even get into that. Cell membranes and soapy water are natural examples of liquid crystals. They both have the ability to form a structure that flows. This property is very useful, and we've found ways to control it, which is why most modern electronic displays are also liquid crystal based. We can control the order of the liquid crystals used in liquid crystal displays with electricity. Think of it like a valve for light. We can open and close the valve by changing the alignment of the liquid crystals using electrical fields. With 256 combinations and gradations of on or off or in between, more than 16 million bright colors can be made into very sharp images. Future liquid crystal research will bring us thinner and more efficient LCD monitors and televisions, and current research combining liquid crystals and nanotechnology will bring us one step closer to true three-dimensional holographic images. Although they're neither one nor the other, liquid crystals are a singular force for the future.